Hi, I am Chef Leah Cohen, and today we are making a recipe from my cookbook, Lemongrass and Lime, and we are making arroz caldo, which is essentially a congee. So every country in Southeast Asia and Asia has a version of this dish, and my version is from the Philippines. All right, so we're gonna start by cutting the aromatics. We'll start with the onions. When I cut onions, I don't care like how long I've been cooking for, I honestly cry every single time. And then we have some garlic. Like, can you see my eyes watering? I feel like I should do like a tear break. And then we have the ginger. I'm gonna literally wipe my tear away. So we're gonna start by cooking the boneless, skinless chicken thighs. And I just really prefer chicken thighs over chicken breast because I think it has so much more flavor. So we're searing the chicken thighs in the canola oil. You're gonna cook it basically like 2 to 3 minutes on each side, but you're not cooking it all the way through because it's just gonna cook in arroz caldo. So it's time to flip the chicken over. I'm just gonna use a spatula because we're not using a nonstick pan, and I just wanna make sure that I kinda get it off. All right, so it's been about 2 minutes on the other side of the chicken, and I'm just gonna remove the chicken from the pot. Once that's out, the chicken's out, we're gonna start sauteing the onions. You don't really wanna get color on the onions, you just want to get them nice and soft. So the onions are nice and soft. It's been about 5 minutes, and we're going to add the garlic and the ginger. So we're just gonna let this cook for a couple more minutes. Now that the garlic and the ginger is cooked, we're going to add our jasmine rice and our sticky rice. And I think that it adds a really nice texture, but you can just use jasmine rice if you don't want to use sticky rice. And you can also use day-old rice if you want to figure out a way to get rid of rice that you had from the night before and you don't want to make fried rice. And we're gonna lightly toast it like you would do in the style of a risotto. And honestly, this is not traditional at all. I just grew up cooking Italian food and I spent a lot of time cooking in Italy. So this is kind of my thought process behind that. Okay, great. So it's been about 2 minutes. The rice has gotten a little toasty. We're gonna add back the chicken to the pot, and all that juice that came out of the chicken, we're just gonna add into the pot. And then I am using chicken stock instead of water. And then I'm just gonna season it with some fish sauce. Tastes good. Okay, so the chicken is ready to be taken out. It's been about 30 minutes, and we're just gonna take the chicken out so we can shred it. And we're gonna keep cooking the arroz caldo because we basically want all of the liquid to be absorbed by the rice and for the rice to start breaking down. And we are just going to shred the chicken, and then we're gonna put it back into the arroz caldo. And then we're just gonna put everything together. There are a couple more garnishes that we need to take care of. We have some scallions, and I just want to thinly slice them. I have some crispy garlic, which is basically minced garlic that has been fried and then drained on a paper towel. And then we have the egg that I sous vide. If you don't want to do this at home, you can do a like medium boiled egg or hard boiled egg or a soy cured egg. It's totally up to you. I just really enjoy a runny yolk. Okay, so now it's time to plate. So I'm gonna take some of this delicious thick arroz caldo. I like to get a slotted spoon if you're doing a sous vide egg. Just pop that in the middle and then garnish it with a little bit of scallions. I completely forgot to add the black pepper, so we're just gonna add some on top. And then we have the crispy garlic. I'm gonna take a little bit of soy sauce and just kind of drizzle it around the edge. We have a lime today. I have a lime. I wish I had a calamansi. You can also use lemon and just squeeze a little on top. And I would also say just like serve it with like a little bit of a wedge, maybe. And then I have some chili oil. I'm just gonna get that really nice yolk going, break that yolk. This is Literally, I need everything that I want to eat in the morning for breakfast. It's so comforting. It's so easy to make. You can just literally use your leftover rice or things that you would find in your pantry. But I highly recommend you making this dish. You can click the link below for the recipe, or you can purchase my book, Lemongrass and Lime, which has so many amazing recipes, not just the arroz caldo, but it'll show you how to make the crispy garlic, how to make fried rice, anything your heart can desire for Southeast Asian cooking.